In our next video, we're going to graph the velocity of an object that starts from rest, like a subway train, accelerates at 0.5 meters per second squared for the first 60 seconds, then maintains that speed for the next 240 seconds, which is 4 minutes, and then slows down at 1 minute per second squared for 30 seconds. And so here's my graph. Starting out at rest, so velocity is zero, then accelerates, and of course it accelerates at a half a meter per second square for 60 seconds. That means it reaches a speed of 30 meters per second. So in the first 60 seconds, the speed goes from zero to 30 meters per second. Then for the next 4 minutes, or 240 seconds, it maintains that speed. So the speed does not change. It stays at 30 meters per second until another 240 seconds or 4 minutes have passed. And then for the last 30 seconds, it reaches the next station. It slows down at minus 1 meter per second squared for the next 30 seconds. So from this point right here, it slows down and comes down to there. And that's your velocity graph, or your velocity versus time graph of such a subway train. Now, what does the slope represent of this graph? The slope is the rate of change, the dv dt, or the rate of change, I can also write delta v divided by delta t, is the rate of change of the velocity versus time, which by definition is the acceleration. So the slope of this graph represents acceleration. Here the slope is positive, positive acceleration, half a meter per second squared. Here the slope is zero, zero acceleration, maintains constant speed. Here the slope is negative, it's decelerating, or negative acceleration, at a minus 1 meter per second squared for the next 30 seconds. What does the area represent? Well, the area represents distance traveled, or displacement if these are vector quantities, distance traveled. So let's take a look at this area. Here we have a triangle. So the area of this triangle is 1/2 the base times the height. The base is 60, the height is 30. 30 times 60 is 1800, times 1/2, that means 900. So the train travels 900 meters in the first 60 seconds. Then in the next 240 seconds, how far does it travel? Well, it's a rectangle, so it's height times width, 30 high, 240 wide, so the total there is 7,200 meters. And then finally, in this last triangle, it's 1/2 the base times the height. 1/2 the base is 30, the height is 30, that's 30 times 30 is 900, times 1/2 is 450 meters. And so you can see that the total distance traveled is 8,100 plus 450, or 8,550 meters. So the area underneath the velocity versus time curve represents distance traveled. The slope represents acceleration. So here the slope is a positive 0.5 meters per second squared. Here the slope is 0 meters per second squared. And here the slope is a minus 1 meter per second squared. And that's how you draw a velocity versus time graph for an object that starts from rest, accelerates, maintains speed, decelerates, comes back to rest. That's how you do that.